Hello everyone, Marine here for Hello Bluebird. I'm back with a very pretty and simple card that for a change doesn't include a million images. The second I saw this little village die set, I pictured this card in my head and I'm very happy of how it turned out and I hope you like it too. So this is the new little village die set. I also used the big Christmas greeting stamp set to create my sentiment. Two circle dies from the nesting circle die set. I used the coordinating mountain die from Wilderness Adventure. And two dies from Hill and Dale. I started by cutting a 5.5 by 4.25 inches white panel. I placed the big greeting stamps at the bottom. And then I placed two circle dies above the stems, one slightly smaller than the other. I taped the smaller circle die and removed the big one. And then I sent the paper to my die cutting machine to cut a circle window out of this white panel. Off screen, I cut another panel out of Bristol cardstock. And I placed this Bristol panel behind the window panel. I traced the circle on the Bristol panel using a pencil. And then I used some oxide inks to create the sky on the Bristol panel. I started with some tumble glass oxide ink, next some stormy sky, and I also used a little bit of faded jeans to darken the sky a bit more. Next, I used the small circle die to cut three circles out of Bristol cardstock. And from those circles, I cut three hill borders to set all my little houses. A small border, a medium one, and a larger one. And on those three borders, I applied the same inks as before, tumble glass, stormy sky, and faded jeans. So here we have the three borders and they match the sky quite nicely. Off screen, I cut all the village pieces out of white cardstock, trees, street lamps, houses, mountains, and also a circle that I cut using the smallest die from the circle nesting die set. I temporarily taped the window panel on the oxiding panel using washi tape. And then I attached the hill borders inside the circle using 1 mm foam squares. Thank you. next I stuck my cute village pieces on each border using the same 1 mm foam squares that I cut in half to fit behind those small elements. Next, I attached the smallest trees and street lamps, and those pieces were too small or too thin to be stuck using foam squares, so I simply used liquid glue to attach those elements here and there. Once everything was attached, I mixed some Copic opaque white ink with water and I used a small brush to splatter tiny dots on the white village and this way create falling snow. Next, I created my sentiment. I stamped the word greetings on white cardstock using clear embossing ink. I sprinkled silver embossing powder on the ink that I melted using my heat gun. And I also stamped the word seasons on the same white cardstock using black ink. I cut those words using the coordinating dies. And before assembling everything, I cut a circle frame. I used the same circle dies that I showed at the beginning of the video. I taped them on a piece of white cardstock and sent them to my die cutting machine. So here's the frame. and I assembled everything. I started with the white window panel that I stuck on the village panel using 3 layers of foam tape. Next, I attached the white frame around the village. And then I attached my sentiment. And you can see that to give dimension to the word greetings, I used the coordinating die to cut 3 pieces. I stuck those 3 pieces on top of each other and glued the silver greetings word on top. And I attached those elements below the village. And that's it, the small village is done, super easy and quick to make. And if you want to make it even faster, you can use the patterned papers or colored cardstocks to create the sky and hill borders. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video. Have a good day. Bye.